Hi, my name is Hamid. I am instructor at ASM Educational Center. We are located in Rockford, Maryland. Today I'm going to talk about wildcards. Wildcards are very important for OSPF and access lists. So today I'm just going to talk about wildcards. The next video I'm going to talk about how we can apply the wildcard inside the OSPF configuration and access list. So I think it's very important to understand the basic concept first, then we can get to the meat of the material. So as I mentioned, wildcards are very important in OSPF. There's a two way to represent wildcards. Method number one, sometimes on exam in real life, they give a slash notation, like slash 30, slash 29, slash 27, so on. When they give a slash notation, you have to use a correct wildcard. The trick as follows, you always write 255.255.255 minus, we know a slash 30 is what? 255.255.252. So when you subtract, you get 0.0.3. This is my wildcard that you have to configure under your configuration. Let's do another example, slash 29. Again, the trick is you write 255.255.255 minus, when you convert to this binary, as we know that, that's equal to what? 248. When you subtract, you get 0.0.0.7. This is my wildcard is. Now, if I come down to next example, slash what? 28. Slash 28, again, you write 255.255.255 minus 240. When you subtract, you get 0.0.15. Now, notice that. Slash 30, you know, means what? Block size of 4. As you see, wildcard always one number less than block size. We're going to see that later on one more time. A slash 29 means what? 248. 248 means block size of what? 8. So this will be dot 7. A slash 28 means what? Block 2.40 means block size of 16. Let's do another example. Last one. Again, if you have a slash 24, that means what? 255.255.255.255. That's a trick. Is minus slash 24 means what? All 255. Zero. When you subtract, you get 0.0.0.255. Okay? Hint. When you advertise your OSPF, you need to use subnet ID with the correct wildcards. In the real life, you can use different method, but on exam, especially Cisco exam, CCNA or CCNP, you have to use correct wildcard. So what does that mean? Let's assume that, for example, I have a router 1 connect to router 2 back-to-back. Router 1 IP address is 10.10.10.9/30 and 10.10.10.10/30 for router 2. Now, as we know that .30 means what? Block size of 8. So it's going to be .0, first block, .4, next one, .8, .12, .16, okay? So if this is .9 is, I know my subnet ID is what? 10.10.10.8. So if you want to configure OSPF and router, what you do as follows, you say config T, router OSPF question mark, as we see later on, when you put the question mark, you got to put a process ID. This number can be any number. We talked about this more detail. Then goes the network. You have to advertise what? Subnet ID. That's the key, gentlemen, students, and ladies. 10.10.10.8 question mark. Then you got to use what? Correct wildcard. And we know that for slash 30, wildcard is what? 0.0.3. Then you gotta put what? Area 0. So here you have to use subnet ID. That's for router 1. You gotta do same thing on router 2. You're gonna say config T, router OSPF 110. Again, this number and that number does not have to be same. As we know that this is called process ID, it's called local significance. We're gonna talk this more detail later on next video. You're gonna say network. Now here I want to advertise you better use what? Subnet ID then 0.0.3802. Okay? So that's method number what? One is. Again, method number one is what? As I mentioned that whenever you have a slash notation, you just write all 255 main minus subnet mask, so you get a wildcard ID. Now method number two, very important. Sometimes they give you wildcards. And you have to understand what it means. So what does that mean? Hint, always, the wildcard is one number less than block size. Here's a trick. So on exam, if you see like this, network 10.10.10.0.0.3. What does that mean? It means I'm advertising block size of 4. That means I'm advertising .0, .1, .2, and .3. Why is that? Because this number means one number less than block size. That's another example. Let's see if I have a network of what? 10.10.10.0. Okay, same thing. But the WAKA is 0.0.7. What does that mean? I'm advertising block size of what? 8. So that means I start from .0, .1, .2, .3, .4, .5, .6, .7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? You get the pattern? So that's very important to understand. So again, this was just a short video about how and where we can use the what? The wildcards. Now all of these, I'm gonna have this video, and also we're gonna have notes of these in our website, which I wanna show you. Inside our website, which is www.asmed.com, that's our main website is, if you go here, you see some blogs. You have Cisco CCNA, CCNP, Company A Plus, Network Plus, Secure Plus, CSSP, and also we do community outreach, which is we go out and we help the homeless people. If you're in this area, we'd love to have you here. We're in Rockville, Mela. On Cisco CCNA, if you click here, you see a bunch of videos, I'm sorry, blogs, like configuring router, DHCP, we have a static route. If you click, let's say, DHCP server, okay, in our blogs, not only you see the step-by-step of the notes, everything, we show all the notes for you guys, so we highlight, and also we have the video too. So if you get a chance, come and check our video, and make sure share all of this with the Google Plus, Twitter account, Facebook, Pinterest, or LinkedIn. It can be appreciated for your time, and you have a good day and enjoy it. And I hope to see you next time. And the next video is going to be talking about configuring OSPF. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye.